My name is Leah Lutzen. I am 25 years old, and I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I am currently 4-1. My pro career actually had a little bit of a rocky start.
Plum, I don't know.
That was a good throw by Joe.
I lost a split decision, and it was probably the best thing that could have happened to me.
Lutzen starts to open up.
Leah Lutzen getting loose here.
Because it exposed some of the weaknesses and flaws I had in my game.
Oh, nice head kick.
I ended up coming back the following year and winning my second pro fight. My third and fourth pro fights also ended in finishes. Last January for Invicta, I fought Liz Phillips.
Oh, beautiful head kick by Leah Lutzen!
I ended up knocking her out with a head kick.
Leah Lutzen, victorious via KO!
I ended up getting a call in January to fight Yana Kunitsukaya. So that was when I originally got signed to the UFC. And the fight ended up falling through because Yana got pulled to fight Cyborg. So when I got the call to do this show, at first I actually wasn't sure if I wanted to do the show because I was waiting for a UFC fight. But once I talked to my coaches and we actually thought about it, we thought this was a great opportunity for me to not only create a fan base and get exposure and tell my story, but also knock some of that ring rust off because I haven't fought in a year and a half. I've tried to communicate with Team Whitaker what I need from them, and it's not happening. I don't think they know how unhappy I am. I'm just not getting what I need, and like I said, it's nothing against them. They're great coaches, they're great people. I did so much preparation and work leading up to coming here that I think I'll be okay for this first fight, but I know when I make it to the semifinals, I definitely need to switch to Calvin's team if I wanna do well in my next fight.
You're allowed to change teams.
I'm like 90% sure that I wanna switch after this fight.
I feel like Leah wanting to transfer over to teams is partially based on the fact that she's not getting in the training that she feels like we are.
Have you guys had any guests yet?
No.
We've had guests every day.
Just a different look, which is kind of dope.
We're cool with it, but it's going to be after the fight. Regardless of the outcome, we'll go from there. So if she beats Bea, she can come over. We'll get her ready to fight one of her other teammates that she already had. If she loses to Bea, she can come over and still get in the good training that we're getting in because she doesn't feel like she's training at the level we are.
If they'll let me, I want to. Otherwise, I'm going to get out of shape, and I don't like that. It's not whether I win or lose the fight necessarily. It's how I feel with Team Whitaker in my corner. If I feel comfortable and confident with them in my corner, then I'll stick with Team Whitaker. But if I'm in the cage and I feel completely alone and I don't feel like they're there for me in my corner, then I'm gonna wanna make the switch.
I know you're at Hall through The Ultimate Fighter. We were teammates together, and we actually ended up fighting in the finale together. And we actually became even better friends after the fight.
I was the guy he beat up.
He's actually a really good coach, you know, first of all. And then second, you know, he just has this positivity about him. He brings a good energy to the group. The time is yours, coach.
Let's do it, man.
I live in Las Vegas now, and he told me to come out, be a guest coach, and I just thought it was an amazing opportunity, so I jumped on it.
We're just gonna switch and push it out. That's it, and go right back. Boom. Boom.
Do it.
I thought it was really cool that Kelvin brought in one of his old opponents because they had such a cool fight, and both of them were so unique.
Anything off the front is a lead technique. Jab, front, snap.
When I look back and if I can reflect on the tough experience, it was like a pressure cooker. And in that realm of that short time span, I learned to get comfortable with the uncomfortable.
Just come up like this.
Looking back now, I can say it's one of the best things that could ever happen to me. And these guys right now are in a great position. And if you can go through that, man, you're a warrior.
I'm fighting Vea, and I think the game plan gonna be the stand-up because that's my thing. I wanted to do Thai boxing when I was a kid, but my mom said I'm gonna look like this, so I couldn't. So when I was 20 years old, I started, and my first fight was maybe 1 year after that. I only have 2 fights in MMA, but I'm not worried at all that the girls here like think they have more experience because I have like 25. I think 25. I stopped counting after 20, I think, Thai boxing fights. So I think I have even more experience than the other girls. I won the Swedish, European, and World Championship in Thai boxing, so I mean, I'm not a rookie in fighting, so I'm not worried at all about if someone asks about the experience in the fighting, so.
She's not gonna take the leg and push me down?
I don't think so.
Is she shooting in the middle?
No, she waits to get you up against the cage. Like, she tries to bull rush you.
Lea is just gonna shoot all the time. Put me to the fence and try to take me down.
Wizard bear. Wizard. Yeah. Beautiful.
My ground game is okay, but I don't want Lea to take me down. I mean, I'm still gonna fight, of course, but that's not gonna be my area.
Break it, though.
There you go.
Yeah, nice. Yeah. We just want you to get out of that position.
I feel like Bea, to win this fight, she just needs to be her and then be smart, you know, not let Lea get comfortable in the fight and have her get and take her down and control. We're just gonna have to be the offensive fighter in this fight.
There you go. Looking good, looking mean.
To win over Lea would be the biggest win for me because, like, the biggest win in the whole house, I think, because she's already signed by the UFC. So me with 2 fights and winning over a UFC signed girl, that's a big win.
I've been matched up with Bea in the first round. I was happy because that was the fight I wanted. And I know she's a very tall and long striker. She's a Muay Thai fighter.
Fast.
I think I want to strike with her at first just to see how I do against her. A lot of people don't realize that I have a super long reach. I have like a 71.5-inch reach, and I'm only 5'6", so I have long monkey arms. So I don't mind that she's a taller fighter. I'm gonna be faster. I think I'm gonna be able to create angles. I think I'm gonna be able to land a lot of strikes. And I really want the knockout, but if things aren't going my way on the feet, then I'm gonna take it to the ground.
Do you want to work hard today in the Shark Tank?
Yeah, I definitely want to get the mitt work and like work on strikes into takedowns. That's what I want to do in my fight.
Mm-hmm. I think the communication is better with Lea now just because it's her turn in the spotlight. I think it's her fight. You know, last week we were trying to focus on other fights, and it's hard to give everyone attention when we're trying to focus on each individual fight. But you know, now it's Lea's turn for the spotlight. It's her turn to fight. It's important that the communication is there, that we give her what she needs so that she can get out there and perform.
Watch it begin.
Keep moving. Watch your stance. For Lea, against her fight against Bale, he's working entries, coming in, throwing some heat, coming back out, and then working that takedown, that power double. I think that's Bay's biggest weakness is her ground game, and we're hoping to exploit that. Lea on the fence, go!
At first, I was a little bit unsatisfied with my training just because it wasn't as difficult as what I'm used to.
You know, I'm waiting for you now. Pants,
Justin.
But the past few days, they've really turned things around and they made things a little bit more challenging, a lot more conditioning and fight-specific things and things that I need to work on.
Let's go, Leah.
Keep going to the fence. Keep going to the fence.
Yeah, push your body against the fence. Go.
10 seconds left.
And I think that things are going to go really well from here on out.
Time. Very good work. Very, very, very good work.
And then when you win, you're gonna be like,
when you what?
When you win, you're gonna be like,
bitches.
Yeah. Gonna get my f-ing lashes done, bitch.
I got pressure now because they call me pretty face. This is the application, BBB.
That's honestly, that's something that you're probably gonna endure a lot.
Yeah.
I think people think that I'm just a pretty girl and I can't fight, but that's not the case. I do care about how I look. I like fixing my lashes, my hair, my makeup and things like that. I mean, that doesn't make you a worse fighter because of that.
This is from my window.
I grew up in Stockholm, like not in the city. I grew up in a place called Tullinge, a small place outside of just it's in Stockholm, but not in the city of Stockholm, like 30 minutes with the car.
This is my brother.
Hello.
I don't have any boyfriend or husband or anything. Right now, I live at my parents' house.
So it's gonna be in the garden. It's a smaller project.
It works right now because when I'm there, they're not there, and when I'm training, they're home. So, I mean, we don't get on each other's nerves.
So, here we have strawberries.
I'm very into, like, healthy food and lifestyle.
And this is where I get all the greens.
So, my mom has, like, a big garden, so me and her, we have plants, we have cucumbers, tomatoes. Anything you can find.
The cucumbers are higher than me.
It's kind of my hobby to be in the garden. I like it because it makes me like relax. It's like meditation for me, I guess.
We're on our way to my second home.
I train at All Stars Training Center in Stockholm.
Hall of Fame.
We have a couple of UFC fighters in our gym. Ilir Latifi, Alexander Gustafsson, Daniel and David Tamer. I personally have really hard to get along with girls. We have a professional group in the mornings and usually it's like 20 guys and just me.
So right now I'm at Gabby's place and I'm gonna fix my lashes. I do it every 3 weeks to look beautiful.
I just think that I have to win to show people that I'm not just a pretty face. Like, that's right now what I think the most of, like, I have to win to show them. Because I hate people who's like, oh, she's just on the show because she looks good or something. That pisses me off. Hey.
I don't make very much money. I'm pretty poor. That's why I live in the ghetto.
You live in the ghetto?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
There's shootings on my block all the time.
So I live in the ghetto, the south side of Milwaukee. It's pretty rough. We've had several shootings since I moved in, like, a year ago. We actually had a shooting right in front of our place and a murder just down the street from where we live. So I would really like to make some money so I can afford to move out of that area.
It doesn't look like you live in the ghetto.
Oh, but I do. That's why I have a concealed carry, a gun.
Yeah?
Yeah, I have to.
So right now I have to conceal carry just to feel safe in my neighborhood.
This is crazy.
You live in my neighborhood, you have to have a gun.
I like guns and I like concealed carry and it just makes me feel safer. But I would like to live in a neighborhood where I don't feel like I have to.
That's why I want to make it big in the UFC. So I can move out of the ghetto.
So it is a beautiful day outside today. I'm gonna show you the neighborhood that I live in. Definitely not the best neighborhood. We've had some shootings, including one right here in front of my apartment here. I live on the first floor and people upstairs are fighters. We call this the fighter house because our coaches, two of our coaches own this duplex here. I currently live on the south side, which is not the best neighborhood, but it's close to my gym and I train about 5 times a day. I live and breathe for MMA, so my entire life is geared towards fighting. My backyard right now, this is my awesome, super extravagant backyard. As you can see, we don't live in the greatest neighborhood. So, we got a grill, but we had to chain it to this tree right here. It's not the best area, but it's pretty much all we can afford right now because living the fighter life, you don't make a ton of money until you make it big in the UFC, so. It's definitely worth the sacrifice.
That's the gym that I train at?
I train at Pura Vida MMA. My coaches are Jake Clip, Zach Otto, Nick Trost, Ben Tomes, and Solo Acosta. Zach Otto is fighting Sage Northcutt next weekend, so he was the first one from our gym to be in the UFC, and I'm the second one. And we have a bunch of prospects that should be in the UFC within the next year or two. Our gym is, I'd say, a smaller gym. It's not one of the big, huge ones like Jackson Wink or Alliance. It's a smaller gym, which is awesome because the coaches are able to work with everyone one-on-one. It's very friendly, we're very welcoming. It's like a big family and everyone knows everyone and everyone's pretty much good friends with everyone. I am definitely an adrenaline junkie. Actually, I love riding motorcycles. I have a Kawasaki Ninja 250. I love it. It was my first motorcycle that I bought when I was 17 years old. It's probably one of my biggest stress relievers in the summertime is to just take it for a cruise. Pretty much anything that is adventurous or exciting, I like to do. Anything that requires a lot of adrenaline, I guess. Say hi to the camera. Say hi.
Hello.
Hi.
We are the EPTs of the 128th ACS. I ended up enlisting in the Wisconsin Air National Guard when I was 19 years old. I've always wanted to serve my country. I wanted to make a contribution and give back.
Up there is the radar.
So I'm a staff sergeant. My official title is electronic protection technician. So that means I work on the radars and make sure that the radar feed is good for the weapons directors.
Our deployment buddies reunited.
Radar love.
Radar love right here.
I was deployed at Al Dafra Air Base in United Arab Emirates. I was there from May last year all the way through the end of November. It was a very, very stressful environment because we were controlling all of the airstrikes on ISIS. It was a very rewarding, very intense learning experience. I think that it helped me mature a lot mentally, and you have to control the stress and the nerves, and it definitely helped me with my fighting career, I believe.
All right, guys, let's do this. Welcome to the Tough 28 weigh-ins. To the scale, please. Leah Letson.
Bea versus Leah is a really interesting matchup. Bea has a really good striking. She was a World Muay Thai champion in 2016.
146.
But Leah is ridiculously strong. She bad girl is strong. On the ground, I think Leah has a domination, so it will be interesting to see who will bring her game plan.
To the scale, please. Bia Malecki.
I think that Bea's coming in as an underdog just because she's not as known, but she is very awkward as a fighter because she's really tall and she looks really nice, but she punches so hard.
145.
This is gonna be a really good fight and I'm putting all my money on Bea. If you know Bea, she's like this pure Swedish girl, and then at the weigh-in, she wasn't 10, she was a bad bitch. She put her forehead against Leah, and it was really cool to see, and I can't wait for the fight.
When I cut weight, I get really like in the mood to fight. So when we do the face off, I was like, it's on, it's on, it's a war.
You guys look like skeletons. Like, look at you.
We can be fashion models now.
When we came home, kind of like settled down a bit and we did our hair, both of me and Leah. We put like things on our head. And we were just joking around.
Karla's not laughing, hold on.
She's about to die laughing.
I actually look like my grandma when I was looking in my mirror. That was weird. Looks so funny. No. We just joke around, I mean, it's fun.
You gotta look like a grandma.
Yeah, you look way funnier than she
did. It is a little weird for me hanging out and talking with Bea. I usually don't like talk to my opponents or see them at all before fights, so it's a little bit weird.
No, wait.
But it's strictly business. Like, I don't have a problem with her personally at all. Once the fight's over with, I think it'll be even less awkward, at least for me, because I'm gonna win.
This is the biggest fight in my life. Like, you can take all of my Thai boxing fights, all of my MMA fights, you name it, like, this is the biggest fight in my life. I feel ready, I feel really ready.
Hit and don't be hit. In, out, fast, hit it hard. Once you go in and you hit it with your power, it'll change the whole fight.
I've always been a super dedicated perfectionist. When I was back in school, I got straight A's. I graduated magna cum laude from college. Everything I do, I put 110% into. I am the hardest worker that you'll ever meet. I put everything into whatever I choose to do. So I will be successful at anything that I choose to do.
I'm usually not the person who say, oh, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. But I really think I can win this competition.
Good luck, eh?
Awesome. Thanks, sir.
I started BJJ. I was training for 2 weeks, then I went to a competition, and I won because I'm a fighter, like I have it in my blood.
I feel like I've covered everything and more. I've literally been training like I've had a fight for the last 6 months, and most people can't live in fight camp. I've been living in fight camp like basically permanently.
Good luck, guys. All right, good luck.
I'm confident that things will go my way, but I have no regrets even if they don't, because there's nothing I could have done more to prepare for this. There's no way that Bea has trained as hard as I have. There's no way that anyone has trained as hard as I have. I think I'm ready. I'm sorry, Bea, but I came here to win, and that means that I'm gonna have to either knock you out on the feet or on the ground. So I'm sorry in advance.
You can't describe the feeling when you walk into the octagon. I change my whole mind when it's time to fight. It means so much. I think it's gonna be a bloody fight. I just feel so happy, and I mean, this is really important. Like, I have to win. I have to win. There's nothing else.
We're right here. Just listen to us, okay?
All you, Bea. All you. This is your fight.
Take her down whenever you want. Control on the ground. She's got no ground. But you're just as nervous as you are. You're just better than her. You're just better than her.
You ready?
Yes, sir.
Ready? Fight!
Position!
We're bumping our hips!
circle to your right. Yes, but you need the underhook. You need the underhook, though.
Holy.
Very good, very good, very good, very good.
See the towel.
Very good, Leah, very good. Leah, don't let up, all right? You've got the pressure on. You're having a lot of success with the takedowns. Get those takedowns. Get those takedowns, win this fight.
You push and then you circle.
You circle with the front punch. Until you're ready to go win, all right? You're doing perfect.
Second round, fight.
Blaster, blaster, bam, blaster. Yeah. Again.
She can't come to your jab.
Again.
Yeah!
Good work, Leah. Control that arm. Control that arm. Good girl.
Up easy. Fight.
Round one, they touch gloves, and then right away the action starts. They come in real aggressive, both of them. Leah has a very hard style. Her pressure game is really good. She's getting hit, but she doesn't mind getting hit. She comes with punches of her own.
Oh. Leah's not judging the distance very well. Bea was able to step in with the right elbow and gave Leah a nasty gash on her forehead. But then eventually, Leah pushes her up against the fence and gets a takedown and starts to control the fight on the ground.
Look at the blood on her, and it's not hers.
That's no fun.
So first round's over, and I felt like Bea did really good. Leah is breathing really bad. She has her face beat up pretty bad, and even Bea has blood all over her face.
Fight!
So round two starts. They're trading punches, they're trading kicks. At one point, Bea even had half of Leah's back. She had sunk in a rear naked, but she doesn't have the hooks in, so Leah was able to reverse the position and take Bea down.
Keep it there!
So Leah controls the entire second round. Finishes up in guard, just racking up points, doing damage, and you know, it's a pretty clear victory in my eyes.
Stop. Up easy. Go. Okay, the winner by unanimous decision, and moving on, Leah Letson.
Woo! She was actually a lot tougher than I anticipated. I didn't execute as much as I wanted to. I felt like I should have used more head movement, more feints. Obviously, I should have used more head movement if you look at my face right now. But it was good. I was able to control the fight. I was able to execute my game plan. I'll take the win.
I didn't win, but I'm still happy that I did a really good fight with such a good fighter. She was better. There's no excuse. So you just have to go back, work harder, and come back stronger.
So my heavyweight pick is from Team Whitaker, Juan versus Ben. Juan versus Ben. So I think that's a good matchup. You know, Ben hits very heavy. He's got a solid all-round game. Juan's very big. I think if Juan wants to walk away with the victory, he needs to push into Ben, take him down, control him on the ground, tire him out, and just control him there.
We felt like Ben was